Hi everybody, it's Janet, and we're here at Fruit of the Vine Art Studio in Cincinnati, Ohio, and I really appreciate you being here with me today. It's a freezing day outside, and, you know, I don't know, we got snow here, and I've been having a lot of fun doing these nature-type winter scenes where I've got the cardinals, and then I did the two deers in the forest, and then the pretty red fox. Well, today I'm going to do a similar type thing. I'm going to also have that orange background going on, and I'm going to do three geese. And I've kind of got it drawn on here just a little bit so that you can kind of see what I've got. Three geese in the foreground, and then it's just going to have a background back there, snowy, wintry. So without any further ado, I guess I'm just going to tilt you down and zoom you in, and we're going to go ahead and get started. That looks pretty good. That might be just a bit too large. It doesn't really want to seem to get right in between. That looks pretty good right there. We're going to go with that. So the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to get some orange on my palette. And I'm going to use some water. And water it down quite a bit, because really what I'm wanting is to just get the orange tone on the background. So I'm going to get some water. I'm going to use my old chip brush. I'm going to water down this orange paint real thin. And I'm just going to use that to create this orange undertone on my painting, an underpainting, as they call that. Underpainting with orange today. Just like we've done the last couple of times. Now my brush is wanting to lose some hairs, so I'm going to try to sweep that off. Get a little more here. Mix that in just a little bit. And I'm trying to keep it thin so that I can see through it and still see my pencil work. And this is so when you paint, there'll be, there's always little spots and little areas where the paint can be, where the canvas can be seen through your paint. And this way there's paint on the background of every bit of it, and it gives an undertone, sort of a shading, a shadow of sorts. And I want to do it fairly thin. That's a little thinner than I want up here. Let me add a little orange to it. And you don't want to have your pencil too dark either, because the graphite does want to get caught up in this for some reason. I'm not sure why. And it wants to smear just a little bit. So you just do a very light drawing and then a real thin layer. And it might be because of the water might be why it makes the pencil smear so badly. I'm not sure. But I don't want the pencil to get real crazy bad, so get a little more down in this bottom area. That'll have a lot of snow in this area too, though, so I'm not too awfully worried about that being. But I don't want this big hair to show on it. one. Let me get this. Pull them hairs off as I sweep across. Looks like cocoa hair. Blame it on the dog, huh? Blame it on the dog. Looks like Coco's hair. She's here somewhere downstairs. Okay. Now you can still see them through there. They're very thin, or very, very light back there, but this will give the whole background a nice orangish tone. Okay. Let's see if I've got you in the right area here. Yeah, I think that'll work. I think that will work. We're just going to put this brush down here in the water. And we're going to get us out a little bit of blue and a little bit of white. I want a darker blue. Where's my... Yeah. I want the dark blue out. Get that off of there. And a little bit of white paint. Waiting on this to dry real quick. I might have to get my heat gun here in a second and make it happen real quick because I want that to dry. Let me just grab my plug. I'm gonna have to wipe the floor. I got some orange paint on the floor over here. No time to clean it now. Now is not the time, huh? Yeah, I get it. Okay, I'm gonna turn this on. Hey, Buck! I can't see what it says. Hello, how are you? I'm just gonna heat this. I'm not gonna heat it, I'm gonna dry it. But I am gonna heat it as well. Just to hurry it up and get it moving. Take me just a moment here, guys. It's right in here. Right in here. Oh, I have to tell you how much I love this heat gun. That is so quick and not nearly as loud as my hairdryer. That hairdryer was quite loud. Now, I know you probably can't see much through this, but don't worry about it. That's okay. We're going to start with making some sky in the background here. Let me get my brush, and I'm going to mix just a little bit of white and blue together. Just a little bit of blue on my brush, and then get me some white, and I'm just gonna kind of start working back in here with this. Just work a sky in the background. A little more blue and a little more white. Let's see, it kind of comes down over here. And I'm just going to leave a small area in the middle for each of my birds because I've got some birds in the sky here, some other geese flying away, and they're not quite in formation, but they're there. Just a little spot for them to be. Kind of work that into the background a little better. I really should just paint the whole background and then put the birds in the sky, but I'm kind of got them already placed where I want them, so I'm gonna try to work around that a little. Get a drop of water in here. Even get a little more paint mixed. Just gonna kind of bring it right in here. It's a bit lighter than what I had, but that's okay because we'll just blend it together and it'll all be fine. Oh, I forgot to turn off my notifications again, guys. Once again. Excuse me. And I'm not too picky about how the edge of that looks at all, because that's going to be some trees in the background. And let me get a little bit of orange out since I've used all my orange up. Just gonna get a little touch of that on my brush. I'm just gonna kind of sweep a little bit of orange color in here. Need a little more. Just a little bit. Little orange in the sky. Just a little bit up in the top, just a little orange in the sky back there. Now we're going to work on some orange, so I'm going to rinse this off. And I'm going to get a little bit of red. To mix with my orange. And a little bit of yellow. Okay, so I'm going to start with this. Oh, wait a minute, I gotta get my mountain back in there. I almost forgot about putting the mountain. I do have a mountain area. Let me just use a little bit of the darker blue. Because we need that to be, let's see, where did that mountain start? That mountain starts, that's the trees back there. The mountain's gonna come across right through here. Trying to look in my background and it's a little hard. Gonna take this dark blue and just sort of sweep it around back here in the back, bring it up. bring it down some so that it'll be in the background behind these trees. Get a little lighter over on this side. I want it to be darker over on this side. That needs to come on down through here. I'm just using a navy blue for this area. And this round brush, and I'm just sort of mashing it in here. Let me see, how far across do I need to go here? I need to go like this. About like that. Gonna bring that up in the middle a little bit. I'm just kind of smashing it around, as you can see. I'm not really trying to make any kind of design with it. I'm just sort of smashing it around in here. Got a little carried away and went down a little further than I should have, but that's okay because we're going to make it work anyway. Let me turn it this way. Bring that along like that. Okay. Mix me in some of the white. And we're just going to bring that back in here. Yeah, you can see where I'm at. I was thinking, can you even see where I'm at? Sometimes I get carried away and don't really pay attention. We're just gonna mix this blue and white going through here. And then I'll lighten that up in a second here after it gets a little dried. I'm doing things all crazy. Okay, now I'm gonna rinse this brush. And I'll come back to this in just a second. I'm gonna get this orange, a touch of that red. I'm just gonna start adding some color back in here. Get a little more of that that orangey red. Get a little more of that red. Get right in with the blue in here. Just mashing it along. A little more of the orange. Maybe a drop of the yellow. A little more of the yellow. Maybe a little more of the red. Put that right in here. A little more of the orange. A little more of that yellow over here on the side, a little bit. Now, you know how some trees in the winter kind of keep their leaves just a little bit longer, those sort of like sycamore trees or whatever they are, those trees, you still see them out there and they've got some leaves on them. That's kind of what we got going here. We got some trees with some leaves. Even though it's winter, this is going to be a little darker on this side. Now I'm still going to get that orange in here. Brighten that just a bit. Okay. I think that's probably going to be enough of that for in the background there. You'll see it in a second here once we get some tree line and stuff like that. It'll start working. It'll start looking, making more sense to you. Okay. I'm going to get this dark blue now. And I'm going to work on straightening me a line here. Doesn't have to be perfectly straight, but I'd like it to be kind of straight. Let just a little bit of that lighter blue slide through with it. on across. See if that looks about straight. Well, not really. Let's make it a little. Trying to straighten it out, guys, and I'm really not having a good go with that at all. That's okay. Bring that up a little bit higher right in here. That'll work. Let's see, this is going to be an area of water, and it's going to come to about right here. So let me just work on putting the blue in here. Let me get some more of it out. Just gonna fill this in with the blue for the moment. Be careful what I'm doing with it. Try to. There goes my notifications again. I forgot to turn them off. I'm sorry. Yeah, it is, man. I forget every time. Let's just bring that right over the top of his head. Put a little more blue back in this area. Is going to come across right in here. So this will be our edge of a lake. Hard to see with the lights in here. Push that up. There we go. Got to be a little bit darker right there. That's too see-through. Add a little darker blue right in here. icy cold water. It went down a little far again. That's okay, we'll just fill it in. Right across his back. It's hard to see my lines. That's why I was trying to make such a thin orange underpainting so that I could see through it real good. And it's actually kind of hard to see through. And that could just be because of the lights. The lights in here make it hard. The three geese are standing on the shoreline over here. They say that means when your hand's itching, my hand's itching. Time to go wash your hand. Maybe that's what that means. Haven't got, well, yeah, I do got paint on it. Don't say that. I do have paint on my hand. I was going to say, I haven't got paint on it yet. That wouldn't be telling the truth now, would it? I do so have paint on my hand. But there's nothing new to that. And in fact, if you don't have some paint on you when you get done painting, I don't know if you was really painting. I don't know what you were doing. Not really sure what you're doing. Yeah, well, that's sort of the typical thing here. Not really sure what I'm doing. I'm just doing. We're just experimenting and going to see how it turns out. Come right through here and let's see, it should go, oh, it is kind of going downward, isn't it? It goes this way. The edge of the water is going this way. Something like this, something like this. just draw it on there, whatever. Sling it around a little bit. I got paint all over. What is that, a big boogie? Yep, you gotta go, dude. Don't want you on the painting. That's okay. I'm not going to worry about that at all because there's going to be snow down in that area, so there'll be blue mixed in it. This could be one of those early snows that came before the trees got to lose all the leaves. Maybe that's what's happening here. I don't know. I just wanted the orange leaves in the background. Just to kind of pretty it up. Give it a little more life to it than just another barren snow background. We are having just, you know, it is winter. True, 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 true. And you have to expect that there'll be snow. Which there is. Let's see, that goes right like that. On that back. Okay, let me just put a little more dark right in here. Tilt this up where I can see. Trying to make a little bit flatter looking strokes here. Since this is just a don't get too close to the top of his head. Just smearing it along here, guys. Let me get a little bit here. Okay. Now we can kind of see the ducks taking shape on the shoreline here. Ducks. Geese. Ah, that's what I'm talking about. The geese are taking shape in the shoreline here. Okay. Let me get this. Brush. Get a little bit of this blue on the tips of it. Just a little bit. We're just gonna kind of drag it up into the trees from down, up into these trees from down here at the bottom. And I'm just trying to get it right on the tippies of this. And yes, I will have to go back and work on the snow beneath them. But I'm just trying to get the look of some trees coming up into it here. This one. Let me get some white. And I'm going to make a couple of trees coming. Right up out of here. Now let me see. Maybe I should have started with black underneath that so that would look better. Let me get a little drop of black out here. Okay. Mix that kind of together there. And then we'll have a limb come off and maybe another limb going that way. And then we'll make another one over here going in this direction and we'll a little piece coming off of there. I'll just draw. A couple of little sticklers coming out back here. We're just putting a few of them back in here. Trying to pull up and away. Up and away. And not all trees are straight, so you got to remember that. Don't make them all going just up. Some need to go kind of sideways and maybe have a little bit of a limbs coming off in different little spots. Don't want to get too much in that blue there. So I'm just dragging a few little trees in the back here. And then I'm going to go over them a little bit with white. So they'll look a little more like the sycamore. And let's see, we'll put one over here that kind of comes up and goes off. You might see a little limb up in the top area somewhere here and there. So I'm putting a couple little limbs up there. Just adding some trees back here. Ooh, don't drop the brush. I've been known to do that. Just be holding onto the brush. Next thing you know, I just drop it right in the middle of the painting. Just like, what the heck? Just some random branches. Just sort of back there in the background doing a few different little odd things. Just odd little trees. Maybe we'll make another one down in here. Just the little Y shape off of there, and bring this one over that way, and a couple little darker spots in the back here. Kind of just sort of going to leave it sort of like that for a moment. Going to go and get this one's too thick. He needs to have a there, something coming out that way. Couple little trees in the background right there. Don't want to get too crazy with it. Add a little bit of white to them. Let me get that wet. I'd like it to be thin, thin, thin. Thin as I can get that. I'm just going to kind of not all of them, just some of them, just some of the bigger ones right here in the front. We're going to just kind of highlight a little bit more. Let me just do this one. Maybe you'll see a little white piece coming out over that way. Come down right there. Coming down right there. See how that kind of just helps the trees just a little bit. It doesn't have to be, you know, perfect or anything like that. We're not going to be too worried about it. Now that's looking on the end of my brush. Let me get a little thinner. And just make one here. One stick in there. Get me a little more water. Get it down. That way on this one, we'll just kind of just so they show up a little more, just to give them a little more character back in here. Just gonna kind of leave it like that back there in the back. I'm gonna add some more snow to the underbelly of them here, and maybe just a little bit of orange brush at the bottom here. Let me get a little more orange. Mix that with a little red. It's a little bright. I don't want it to be too bright. I don't know that I want it to be there at all. Maybe we'll just put a little bit in and just touch it off. Just kind of adding a little down at the base of the trees. Like little bushes on the ground down here. Now, I told myself I wasn't going to do tons and tons to this because I didn't want it to take hours to get it done. I don't want to spend 2.5 hours up here because I know you don't want to spend 2.5 hours watching me paint. Right? I understand that. Yeah, I do. Just adding a little bit of orange in there underneath. Let me get a little more of that. Just in a few of the spots. Right down at the bottom of those trees. Gonna put them at the bottom of the trees, those little orange rushes sticking up. And then we'll fix that with a little white in just a moment. And just get it mixed up here. This will just sort of anchor the trees a little more in the snow. Okay. Get this brush. And we're going to work on the snow right in here, and we're going to leave a little bit of blue in some spots, and we want it to be a little clumpy looking on the edges. Don't want it to be too white though. We need some of the darker blue to be like a bit of a shading of the trees here. Bring that through right here. Okay. Get a little more of the white. Just kind of clumping it along the edges here. Open it down this way. You can see the snow starting to build back there across the water. Bit wider where the don't want to get too close to there. Let's see, we need to put some snow over here. Clumped up under these trees. A few little spots where it might be a little higher over there. Always add some blue highlight to it. For now, I'm basically just trying to cover up all the little hairy area down here where I used my chip brush to make the blue tree trunks. I'm trying to get over top of that so that it doesn't show through like that, and the tree trunks can just be seen in the background and not now. We've got snow back over there, and we'll add a little bit of blue to it. And just a couple of spots here, we'll make a little shading coming this way. A little bit of shading over here. Across the bottom of it. There we go. Let me rinse this off. And just use a Q-tip here. Let me get it wet and just kind of right along the top of the tree here. Is that going to do what I want it to do? I don't think so. Okay, then we won't do that. Get this little brush. Mix him with a little bit. Just gonna kind of put a little bit of shading, a little bit of darker in a few spots. Just putting little bits of shade. On the front, where there's a few little leaves. So that the lines aren't so perfectly straight looking, actually, is what I'm trying to do, is trying to break up the lines a little bit on the trees, because they need a little bit of leaf in the front of them as well, just like over here, a little bit there. I think I need to leave that alone. Quit messing with that. Tell you the truth. Just quit messing with that. I'm not real crazy about that blue. Put a little bit more right in here. I can see too much of the background through there, and that's just bugging me. I don't want that much of the background to show through. Okay, so let me get a little more of the blue in this area, wet a little bit. You're probably thinking, what are you doing that for? Well, I'm going to take this brush. Some lines in the water down here. Don't want to get too far over there because I haven't added anything to that yet. Just a couple of lines and little pieces. And then we're going to get a little bit of the orangish red. And just put some of this in here. Take this brush right here, and we're just gonna kind of sweep it a little bit, light as a feather. Okay, we'll try that again. Let's get the blue. Put some blue down in here. I need it to have a little bit of wetness back here so that it can help the trees move when I go to do a little sweeping with that. And this needs to be a little darker down in here. Okay, get the black, make a line here and a line there, and we'll have one here and there and there and there, here and here. Get a little white. Put those there. Get this brush again, hit a little bit of this orange and red. Get this brush. Sweep it a little bit. You can see it's making a small... We'll have white over top of that too, so don't worry about that. Let me get this red, orange, and kind of make it come down this way just a little bit. Touch this in this water. Sweep it back and forth a little more so that it kind of blends it out just a little bit. I'm not worried about it being on that either. Okay, so we're going to keep doing what we were doing there. I'm going to get back to the... Where's that white brush? Here it is. Get the black. And just sort of pull this one this way and this one that way and one here. One coming up that kind of curves and does that. Here's this one. Here's that one. couple other little trees down in there. Okay, we'll get a little bit of white and just drag it next to it. Sort of like that a little bit. A couple little spots in there. Get this brush. Where is this brush? Get this brush. Get me some more of this. A little oranger this time. Okay, and then we're gonna start putting some of that down in here. A little bit up that way, out this way. Oop, messed that up. Let's get this. Just drag it back and forth. So you can see how the trees are kind of blurred up in the water a little bit. The white does a good job of blurring for you. All right, let's keep moving. I'm going to put some snow. I'm going to have a snowbank that comes in over here. But for now, we're going to start working on this in the background back here. So I'm going to get me some white. Bring it right along through here. Here against his leg. Get me a touch of the blue. Work a little of that in there for some shade. Go back to the white. His little knobby knees right here. Just leaving an outline for myself so that I can see where his feet are going to be. Give me a drop of the blue. Get that back in there. Between his legs. Okay. I want some of this blue to move along right here as well. I need more white paint. Snow right there. Right in between your little skinny legs. Oh my, how'd I get that in there? I know how. I had it too close to my blue, to my white. That's all right. There we go. Get that off. All right. Didn't hurt a thing. I'll just move that along through there too. Let me see. Let me turn it. Right over here between you two fellas. Not like that. Here, let me get a little more paint. There's where your little flat foot will be. His legs. Trying to see where's his tail feather. His tail feather comes right there, and there's the wing. And then this is curved right there, yes. Okay, now let's see. I need to get just a little bit of the blue. Just a small amount. Mix it up. Get me some of that shading. And that's going to go right in here. Let me get a little more of the blue. That's not shading enough. We've got a spot that's going to go right in here. A little bit right here. Get a little more. Darker. Right underneath them. That, get a little more white. kind of see the snow under them and around them and so forth like that. You're gonna do it for me, are you? Okay, well, we can do that with this. Ooh, be careful where you touch. Don't do that yet. We'll wait. I'll just wait to do that. Let's just make that a little wider right in here. Okay, we're going to wait on the rest of the water for a minute here, and we're going to go ahead and flip this over this way. And I'm going to get in the black. Down just a little bit on the edge. Okay, so got one duck or one geese, one goose, a duck, a geese, a goose, a whatever, a floating, a sly, a flying, or whatever it's a doing. It's flying in the sky. Let me thin this black down. It's thick. There, that's better. Now this one's got sort of a awfully odd wing. You bet it is. What exactly is flying up here in the sky? Heck, we don't know. Some big old bird. Some big old bird. Bring that up a little bit right in here. Okay, we got some birds in the sky back there. Let me turn this towards me here. That needs a little help. That's his. With just a little bit of blue, just to fill in some of that. That wing looks funny to me. I don't like it. Too big. looks a little better. That looks a little better back there in the sky. All right, I'm just going to leave those alone the way they are. No, I'm not. You know me, I'm going to go back here and mess with some stuff because I can't let it go. It doesn't blend in. It's not the right color. So I just got to add a little something to it, maybe, so that it doesn't look as noticeable. Okay, I'm going to leave them alone. The more I mess with them, the more I'll keep messing with them. Let's work on our birds. Let me get some of the orange. And we're just going to bring that right through here. This orange bill. This black. I think my water's just like too dark looking. I'm going to add white lines to it, but the watercolor, the content itself is just too dark. Place for his eye. Okay. Just going to keep working on it here. That. Right up around that way. You know, they say that those Canadian geese mate for life. As does a swan. I think there's a few birds that do. Honestly, I'm not sure. I'm not sure. Bring that along that way. This needs to come down just a little bit and then come out. Yeah, that looks better. And I Let me go over here and do the next duck head. I don't want to, or geese head. I don't want to touch this down here, so I'm trying to. Seriously trying to avoid it. Trying to avoid touching that. See, I need some water in that black. Get it down a little bit. Leaving space for his eye. I think I should have started by putting the orange on his beak, but that's okay. It is orange. It'll just be a... Here. Don't want it pointed though. That doesn't look right. Oh, I'll have to work on that. Oh, getting in the paint. I knew I would. Start worrying about that. The next thing you know, you're messing up stuff. Don't worry about it. For now, I can fix it. Right? That's right. I can fix it. Put this right across the here. That looks a little wide. It is. That shouldn't be that wide. That's okay. We'll worry about that as we go. We're just going to go ahead and keep doing this. Working on them. Let's see. Here's this. Right like that. I'm right up over top of it. Getting real close up. Gonna have to scoop back and not stress it. Okay, where's the eye? Where's your eye? I don't see it. That's okay. We'll just leave a space for his eye. That'll work right there. Let me see. This needs to be... Just a little bit rounded here at the end. Let me rinse this off and I'm gonna get some orange and work on that. Curve it a little bit here. With a rounded beak, that looks a little bit better. Instead of making that pointy, shouldn't have a point at the end of it. Okay, so now we can see there are three beaks. Those look all right. We're going to leave that be. Get some white. Okay, that'll work for him. Let's do the next one. Little white patch under their chin. Let me try to get this right through here. Try to smooth it down. Gee, daggone it, come on now. There we go. Paint's not at the tip, it's all up in the brush. I want the paint on the tip of the brush, not up inside the brush. Get him a little white eyeball. All right. Our three heads are taking shape here. I do think the water needs to lighten as it goes this way. I'm going to have to add a little bit of lighter to it, I think. I think. Let's put that right there. Okay. Now, we've also got this white chest area here. which I want this to be just a little bit bluer behind him. Let me get this. Lighten this up just a little bit. A little bit bluer in this spot right here. Because I want his little white chest to show up well. Right down here. Get that to fill in a little better. Darken that up just a little in here. See if I can't lighten this water a little bit down here. I'm off on another tangent now, looking at the water, thinking, it needs to be lighter. It needs to be lighter. It's too dark. Don't think I want to go quite that light, though, but we want it to be just a little bit lighter down in here. I'm going to work this in here, so just bear with me for a second. Hey, Carol. Thank you so much. I appreciate that. I'm just sitting here stressing away, not paying attention at all to what I'm doing or who's joining me or anything, and just thinking, well, I got to do something with this water down here. I do not like that. It's too dark. I don't know how this is going to work, Janet, but we're going to see. Because we need to have a little bit of that. The sky is not so dark, so there needs to be a little bit of the reflection of that in here. push it all the way down. Kind of just lighten it up a little bit. Let me wet this. Let me work it from this angle. Bring a little bit of it back that way even. Get a little water to add to here. Okay, you can see it's kind of helping the water a little bit, giving it a bit more of a watery look to it. It was just too one tone, just too dark for the sky to be that light. I mean, there is a dark mountain back there. Yes, there is a dark mountain in the background. But that was just too dark. Don't necessarily want it on his chest, though. Kind of bring it up underneath his chin and kind of smear it around just a little bit. Here, maybe we'll add a little snowbank coming over here. We'll get a little more white. I probably shouldn't, but I'm gonna. We'll just kind of bring that out here into the water, get a little blue mixed in it, down here towards the bottom of it. Bend that down just a smidge. white on the top. Sorry, I'm real quiet, aren't I? We just got a piece of snow come out over here. A little snow bank coming off of the edge there, just a little bit. Just to kind of work that out a little bit. Here, let me. Where is this little brush? Here we go. Get him. Just sort of smooth that a little bit across the bottom. Just working it a little bit across there. Okay. I keep thinking about what I need to do. What I need to do is get this going. Get this painted. That's what I need to do. Get this painted. Okay. Okay, 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 Janet. This is going to need a little bit of reddish orange. A little more orange than that. Where's my brown? It's a little too dark, and I need a little more orange. I'm mixing me up a mess. That looks about right. That looks about right. We'll go with that. Down here, under here. There we go. That that looks a little better. I was thinking somehow that's not working right. But yeah, it is. Just had to work on it a little bit. Okay, now this feather comes all the way. Out there. And this just kind of comes over in this way. And that's about right for here. Okay, now he has a kind of standing with his back to it. So he's going to be a little more orangish than white in this area. We're going to add some white to it because we know he's got this little white chest. But he's also standing in the shadows behind this guy. I'll fix that with black. I'm not going to stress about it, Janet. Don't stress about it. Okay, so that looks about right. And then he has a more browner on the sides here. More of that. And he's brown on this side. About down like that, I'd say. All right, get just a little more right there, darken him up a little bit. Okay, and then this guy, we're going to make him sort of a yellowish. A lighter, yeah, the yellowish brown, I guess, is what you would call it. Old yellowish brown. We're going to put that right in here, too. It's going to be right underneath here. Just a little bit, and a little bit mixed up in here. Leave him a little darker down there at the bottom. He's kind of got a lightish golden kind of colored body, slightly. Just because of the way he's standing there. Get a little bit of black on that right there. Fix that slightly. Okay, now let me see where I'm going to with this. And I need to use some black. And that's going to be starting. Let's see, it's going to go. Just kind of lay it down here and try to smooth it out. That's kind of over here too. Work that up in here a bit. Let me turn it this way so I can pull it in the right direction. Just sort of bringing it along right through there. I don't know if you guys are able to see what I'm doing at all. I don't know if you're able to see at all what I'm doing. His tail kind of comes out over here. Streak of white right there. Dark down in here. Might have to get my other brush here. Right up underneath here. I do not like it. That foot, it's too fat. We'll work on that in a second here. Make this leg come out over this way. Give him his little knobbies on his leg here. That's what might be the problem here, is that's not curved in the right direction or something. I've got it going wrong. Yeah, I do. This needs to go more. Well, I'm going to have to work on that, aren't I? Yes, indeed. Let's see, this one comes. Out a little bit in the back. Okay. Let's get this working. Kind of drag it up like that, make a few more little lines in between. I don't know. Is it looking right? Oh my goodness, Carol. Well, I appreciate that. And we'll see if you're still thinking that you want to buy it when we get done. It might be a complete freaking mess by that point. I don't know. You may not want it at that point. We'll see. Let me just put a few more of these little lines in here. A little bit going back this way. Okay, I see where I need to add the white. I am not happy with that foot. Let me work on that. That's just a wee bit. Wacky. Needs to be more like it. Maybe that helped it some. Don't know. His feet look a little odd. His feet look a little odd, that they do. Let's get some white. Let's see, we'll make a... Make sure I'm getting it in the right spot. It goes... Little white area right here. And then there's a white area that goes right here. I haven't got this done right here. That needs to be more black. The more I look at it, the more I see the things. This needs to come up. Let me get a little more. Curved. More like that. Get the white. Let me see, it could go right through there. Let me get a piece that comes right through here. A little swoop right there. And then we'll make some few little white lines in here. It's like I'm missing something here. It goes right here. And that little line goes right up through here. I think that needs to be a little creamier yellow, a little bit lighter, because that's usually like a white spot on the... Get a drop of water on it. Is it too light now? I'm not sure. Let me get just a little bit of the brown here. And we're just gonna make a little bit of brown in it. A little bit of this creamier needs to be a little bit lighter up on his shoulder area. So I'm going to take that and kind of dry rub it on there, get water on it. Get right into here. There, that gives him a little more of a tone to him than just that one bright orange. I'm reading what you're saying there, Carol. Oh. I am starting a wall of paintings in my front room, and this painting would be a beautiful addition. Oh, Carol, I appreciate that. Thank you. We've still got a long way to go. We've still got a long way to go. Let's just keep going here. We're going to mix a little bit of brown and black. Maybe get a little more black. He's going to be dark down in here. Got a little round bottom. He hate how that comes out so thick. We're going to work with it. His tail just kind of gets lost in here, doesn't it? We'll fix it. Okay. Now for him, he just kind of... Let me pull it this way. He just kind of... Oh, it must be getting late. I'm still painting. Steve's coming in. I hear him. Add a little brown to this. Bit of orange, not too much. Darken him up some on this side. Pull it around this way a little bit. Tilt him up here just a little bit so I can see him a little better. And we're just going to put a little bit of white on him here. Just a little. And then mix that in with a little bit of the orange and the white. He's just sort of got a muted kind of color to him back there. We're just gonna drag this up through here a little bit to get his little tail feathers to show up a little better. His shoulder needs to come over just a little. So we're going to darken this. Up right there. Just sort of darken his shoulder a little bit there. Okay, now this guy, he's going to be more of a brown. He's going to have more of a brown on his back.
over here.
Out this way. Let me get some of this brown down here. Right there. This one's going to kind of come up a little bit this way. Give it more of a curve. All right, and then we've got some, let me wet this just a wee bit. Just make some little lines here on the side of him. That looks about right, I'd say. All right. And then he's got, let's see, that white goes just like this, right down here. Crossed his bottom. Around this tail. Going back to the black. It just kind of comes across right there under this wing. Hope I'm getting that tail shaped right. See how this goes. It's right here, and it gets sort of like that. Just a little shade right there. Okay, and then this is black. In the middle of his back, where it's all dark from the shade. Okay. Let me get this kind of feathered out a little bit. That just barely has the brown showing over here. Brown. Nope, that's not what I wanted it to do. That's better. Let me get some water on it. I'm having a problem with the black. It's thick. Here. And the little legs just come on down right here. Puts down behind that snow on the other side. You don't really see that. Right here. Try to get his leg together right here. Barely see his feet. He's standing on the other side of the snowbank. Got his little skinny legs coming down, little skinny legs coming down. Little bit of a knobby knee. Little bit of a knobby knee. Don't make him too dang old knobby. And his feet are just gonna kind of come out. They'll still be hidden behind the snow, but they're just sort of straightforward, so they're just sort of splayed out a little bit. Don't get goofy with it. Doggone it. Aggravating me. That's a big wide foot on that poor little duck, on that poor little thing. Poor little goose there. We're going to have to work on that just a smidgen. I have to make the snow go back up around their feet again. Smooth that down just a little bit. And he's got a... just a little bit of a shadow there where that's his thigh going up in there. That kind of helps a little bit, I do believe. And we're just going to drag a few little black lines in there for him. Let me see. There. Gotta get some white. Add a little water to the white. Let's see, where does this go? This goes right. Crossed right there. We wipe that off. Right across there on his tail. Cross that tip right there. Wipe that off. Just a little here, a little there. See, he's kind of coming a little more to life here. Let me try to look at it and see what I need to fix here besides the water. Need to do a little fixing on the snow. Which is this white. And it's a little bit of a darker blue. Okay. Huh. White and build this little snowbank here. That's not looking too awful bad. Gotta give them the little black dots on their eyes. Where is my daughter? Here we go. My daughter. Not my daughter. My daughter. It just makes dots. Okay, let's get a little black. Ooh, I'm getting in the white again. Don't I always. Might need a little one for you. That was still a little bigger than I wanted it to be, but I guess that's all right. You can see their eyes. This needs just the tiniest bit of white around it. And I think I'm going to leave him just with the white under his eye instead of, well, I don't know. From there, it looks like it needs it on the top, too. Let me see if I can get it in there. Drop of water. Mixed in the white. Let's see. If not, I'll just put another dot of black in his face. I'm leaving it just like that. I'm not going to mess with that eye anymore. That eye is exactly what it is. Okay. Make a few little lines in the water. Few little lines back here and there. Problem is you got to kind of keep them going straight here, and that's sort of an issue for me. I am not drawing straight today. Let me just kind of I don't know if that's helping my water or hurting my water. Couple lines here, a couple lines there. Yeah, that kind of gave the water a flowy feeling, didn't it? A little bit. I do. I think I should stop. I think if I keep adding more and more to the water, it's gonna eventually just look odd. I think I need to stop at this point. What do you guys think? Just call it done. I've been painting, I think, almost 3 hours. I think it's time to be done. Here, we'll just sign off down here on the bottom. Give me some paint. Okay. That's it, guys. This is done and gorgeous. Oh, thank you, Carol. I'm glad you like it. I really am. Thank you. I appreciate that. All right, guys. I'll see you again real soon. Bye.